This year, we are celebrating the concept that in order to triumph, you have to bring oomph to the table. For us, we are defining oomph as that ability to do hard things. It's the ability to not only face challenges with a positive mindset, it's that ability to recognize the post-growth that happens after overcoming a challenge.
We're going to look at building confidence, identifying feelings, emotions, and then we're going to put that into coping skills. Within the resiliency piece, we're going to work on, even if we have our hardest days, what can we do the next day in order to bounce back, or how can we persevere even when we don't want to.
We know that all kiddos face adversity throughout their lives, throughout the school day, on a playground, and so being able to overcome those challenges and recognize that they can do hard things builds that self-efficacy and their confidence that they can overcome things even when they're challenging.
Always trying to step out of your comfort zone, and because like you can't stay in one spot in your whole life, because you have to move up in life. You won't get anywhere if you don't move up in life.
If we're getting them at a younger age using language like, that's okay, I got this, or I can't do this yet, then they can start to use that language even when they get to high school, college, their career. I mean, this is a life skill that we're building.
The other thing that we are focusing on as a staff is that necessity to provide challenges for our kids. We know that without challenges, you can't build that resilience. As we've been talking about it from an instructional lens, we're really focusing on providing that appropriate level of challenge. We want to scaffold and support kids so they can feel successful, but we don't want to take the challenge away from them. We know it is the challenge that builds those skills, and it also builds that self-efficacy in those kiddos, that realization that they can do hard things.
I like to come to Hong every day because there's a lot of supportive people here. They make you like feel safe here too.
We define success through multiple measures. I think our greatest level of success is to have students who are excited to walk through our doors, feel safe and loved and cared for here at Holling Heights.